Oh, it's all quarantine. It will be so keen. The best you've ever seen. Just don't rupture your spleen.
Hello, people. On the 18th day, Christopher here. Feeling 20 pounds lighter since I got rid of Heavyface. It's almost like I could fly away and arrive at any old place. And the world is much cooler with the lightness that I found. So goodbye to all of the stifling baggage I no longer carry around. Are you suffering from a heavy face with a high degree of pain and grief? If you're suffering from a heavy face, it's about time you found relief. Yeah. It's a sacrifice of coolness to the hipster gods on high for a blissful, invisible feeling as they stroke their beards and wonder why. Are you suffering from a heavy face with a high degree of pain and grief? If you're suffering from a heavy face, it's about time you found relief. When all the things just wear you down and you can't take all that abuse, then that's the time to turn your back and move forward as you could lose. Are you suffering from a heavy face with a high degree of pain and grief? If you're suffering from a heavy face, it's about time you found relief. Are you suffering from a heavy face with a high degree of pain and grief? If you're suffering from a heavy face, it's about time you found relief. Hey. Are you suffering from a heavy face? Hello, everyone. I'm Christopher. Chris Hardy, actually, is what I go by. Never mind the stupid, obscure Star Trek reboot joke. But I am yet another out-of-work musician who has nothing better to do in quarantine than play music. Yeah, that's it. Should you want to tip me, please do so with the links I've provided you below. And that song was, strangely enough, about that one time that I tried to grow a full beard. I mean, a full, a big beard, epic beard. And I discovered quickly in the July heat of Augusta, Georgia, that it just felt like there was a sweater wrapped around my face the whole time. So, anyway, welcome to quarantine show number, where are we? 18, yeah. This is a thing I wrote in 2014 called Fresh Start, which I didn't actually achieve until 2017. And now I might get a fresh start in 2020. And not voluntarily, but we'll see what happens. pain all fades away, and you're left with nothing but air. At least you can still breathe deep, and that's a fresh start right there. When you wash up negativity and you see it go down the drain, your soul then begins to sparkle, 'cause it has no reason to complain. And who doesn't love a fresh start down a path that looks totally new? Yeah, maybe you're unsure what will happen next, but a change is long overdue. Out of you, and you're finally in the clear. No longer are you lost at all. Hey, you can center the map right here. And who doesn't love a fresh start down a path that looks totally new? Yeah, maybe you're unsure what will happen next, but a change is long overdue. You know, can no longer find you, and the devil you don't know doesn't yet know you. On the skyline, and it's on its way out of town. You can bask in the abundance, and you can finally settle down. And who doesn't love a fresh start down a path that looks totally new? Yeah, maybe you're unsure what will happen next, but a change long overdue. Yeah, who doesn't love a fresh start down a path that looks totally new? Ah, maybe you're unsure what will happen next, but a change is long overdue. Yeah. Okay, yeah, it's still in the morning time, and a little bit sloppy, but I'll take it. I'm going to try a cover song that I have never attempted on this here instrument. I used to play it with a band. I was just the bass player, so I could do the bass part, but... Take humiliation and hurtful comments. didn't really work on that ending, but oh, there it is. That was by XTC, called Earn Enough for Us, off their, in my opinion, one of the greatest albums ever made, Skylarking, produced by Todd Rundgren. If you've never heard of XTC, that's a good place to start. Okay. We are in quarantine here. Here's a song I wrote in 2016 about all the political bickering that was going on the internet and in the media. It was particularly vicious, and I just wanted to shelter myself from it. So I wrote this little song here called Underwater, and it's sort of about being in like one of those submerged think tanks where nothing can, that the ugliness can't get in. Kind of a weird song, but it was necessary, I think. Okay, hey, thanks for watching this stuff. I mean, I know you're bored silly at... Do you mind? I'm trying to talk here. Hey, don't use that kind of language. This is a family video. Everyone's a critic. Anyway, I'm Chris Hardy. Thank you for watching. I have one more song. It oddly... pertains to silence. It's called I Can't See the Silence. I can't actually see the source of the noise. Oh! Okay, there's this little bird perched on top of a dead tree, about 35 feet up. All right, featuring the background vocals of Mr. Bird up there. Yeah, this is a little bit of a rock and roll song called I Can't See the Silence. I can't
could see the silence from me to you. Of noise, sometimes a noise, it's always there, just hanging in the air. I can't see the silence from me to you, from you to me. I can't see the silence, my ears and eyes, they don't agree. Clearness I hear, just not in my ear. It's parked up in my brain, just wrapped up in chains. Direct line of communication here just never stops, never ceases, never ends. Even in the absence of any spoken word, the laws of physics will easily bend. So in good time, this paradigm will continue on long after we have gone. I can't see the silence from me to you, from you to me. I can't see the silence, my ears and eyes, they don't agree. I can't see the silence from me.
Any comment? Ah, nothing to say now, do you? I guess I can see the silence. Hey, anyway, I'm Chris Hardy. Be safe out there. Stay at home. Wash your hands. All that stuff that everybody keeps telling you. I'll tell you again, just in case you've forgotten, right? After 18 days of this. Okay. I will see you tomorrow with yet another fun-packed video.
Quarantine mini concert power! Power!